Hi friends, welcome to channel Brainerzizer. In this video we will be making a robotic arm. It is having 4 DOF, base, shoulder, elbow and gripper. All actuators are SC90 servo. I'll be showing A to Z of this robotic arm, how we can make at home, so the video will be longer. So in the part 1 I'll be showing the mechanical things, and in the part 2 I'll be showing the schematic and the coding. Watch this video till the end. You need MDF to make the base. I'm going to use 4 metal stud as stand. Like this. Now at the front, I'm going to make a hole to fit this servo motor. This servo motor is for the base movement. I'm going to glue it using hot glue. Now you need small CDs like this. I'm going to remove the coating and then rub it with sandpaper like this. On top of it, I'm going to glue a servo horn. The servo horn comes with the servo motor itself. Use Fevikwik to glue it and then make it more firm using hot glue. Then I am to stick this with another CD to make it thicker and stronger. So I'll remove the coating of the second CD too and glue it with the first CD. Like this, I'm going to glue both together. I'll have some clips all side and let it dry. Now draw 2 parallel lines from the smaller inner circle, and from around 1/3 of the top I'm going to fit 2 servo motors. These 2 servo motors are for elbow and shoulder, but the servo motors will be on the base disc. They will be not at the elbow corner, so the load will come on the base, not on each other. This is really an important thing for this design, so glue the servo motors here like this. Now I need a clamp, so I'm going to cut an MDF piece. We'll make a drill at exact height of the servo shaft itself. Then glue it with enough glue like this. Now to make the frame or the body of the arm, I'm going to use ice cream sticks. Take 1 stick, blue color stick, make a hole at the front and then attach it with a screw, with a center clamp. Now when you are attaching it with a screw, do not make it very tight. You can use double nut, you can use at the end some hot glue, but do not make it too tight because this point should pivot. Now glue 1 horn at the end of 1 ice cream stick, make a hole and glue the horn tightly and firmly there. Now this is for one of the servos. Insert and pull it to make the servo at 0 location, then make the shaft totally horizontal and fix the stick with a screw. Now these 2 are parallel, so this should stay parallel. I'm going to fit a stud in between these 2. You can glue another ice cream stick, but I'm going to add 2 stud to make it firm. Drill carefully here. So these two frames are parallel and driven by one servo. For the other servo, I'm going to take a half of a ice cream stick, glue one of such horn at one of the end and make a drill at the center. Same way, you insert this into the servo and rotate it to its maximum to the zero point. Then open it, make it horizontal and push it back again. Then tighten it with the servo motor using the screw. Here very limited space you have, so you cannot use a screwdriver. I'm going to use a nose plier. I make two holes at the top. Now I have to add these two sticks like this way. One is horizontal, another is vertical. And those two points we are going to make holes. So make drill holes at those points. Again, all the points we are going to use screw and double nut secured with hot glue. None of them would be very tight because the points should pivot. So here and there two pivot points, and there are some extra sticks, you just cut it out. So this is the elbow movement. That serves the shoulder movement. Now glue one more half ice cream stick. Make a drill at the height of the servo shaft. Use another small piece of stick to make the stand. Now take another. This stick should have a length from center . So I'm now going to make an angle. So I cut two sticks, file these two and glue them with each other. This is very important angle. The angle is ready at the center and both the end, three holes are there. Now take a stick to make another parallel frame, make drills there. Now the angle, the stick, and the servo shaft should be connected together, and the longer arm and this side frame should be in straight line. At this condition, from top to bottom, I have to connect a linkage. So just mark the drill points. Make two holes both the side as per the marking. and then use screw and nuts to make pivot connections. That may be a little longer, so we'll cut it out to make both of same length. Again, these two frame needs to be parallel, so I'm going to make drills both sides and use a stud to keep it in parallel shape. Now, one linkage I need for the pump. That linkage should be connected on the short arm of the angle we made. So that much of distance it should have. Again, put another screw and nut. Don't tight it, as this point should pivot. I'm going to make the pump, so take this kind of two small ice cream sticks, join them together. At top, stick another piece of stick. At the side, I need an L shape, so glue that part, which is 90 degree vertical from the pump. Put enough glue to make it rigid. Put another support there. Now at the end, glue a stud. This stud has both side holes. You can use a small popsicle pipe. You can have a pipe there also. Put the stud and fix that both sides with screw. Now that vertical clamp should connect with the top link. Again, don't make this joint also very tight. So this is the elbow movement. This is the elbow movement. That is the shoulder movement. And this, all the cases, see, the base is always, the grip is always parallel. Now it's time to color. So I'm using acrylic color. Color the base, the arm, and then fit it on top of the servo, which is at the base. Screw it or fit it with the base servo. Make sure it's freely moving. Now I will be controlling this with an Arduino Uno, so I have fit it at the back. This is the gripper which I made in the previous video. For the link, see in the description. This I am going to glue at the front, or with using a screw I'll fit. We can use other grippers, but for this project I'm going to use this gripper. So glue that at the front. This is the shield which I will be using to control. Now the shield, how I'm connecting with Arduino, how I'll code it, all I'll be explaining in the next part. So stay tuned, I'll soon publish it. Don't forget to like the video, share it with your friends. If you like my videos, you should subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click the bell icon to get notification. Thanks for watching. Bye.